guys, welcome back to my channel. If you haven't seen my last two videos, I highly recommend that you go and watch them. They're the foundation for how to become financially successful, which is what this series is all about. I'm trying to give you a step-by-step process of how to become financially successful or financially independent. So in today's video, I want to talk about setting up an emergency fund. An emergency fund basically is money that you have set aside just in case something arises that you didn't plan for and you don't want to go into debt because of this. Unfortunately, a lot of us, myself included, were taught that credit cards are for emergencies, but that's not what credit cards should be used for. I'm going to cover credit cards in a different video, but for today, just know that credit cards should be your last resort for an emergency because they have high interest rates. The average interest rate on a credit card is about 17%. You really don't want to do that. So three things that you should always have money set aside for is a car insurance deductible, a home repair or appliance replacement, and the third one is a medical emergency. In the last year, we've had all three of these things happen to us. We called it the deployment curse. If you're a military family, you probably know what I'm talking about. And that's basically when your spouse is deployed, everything goes wrong. And that happened to us. My AC went out, which was very expensive. My refrigerator went out. My car was hit by somebody in a Walmart parking lot. And before all of this even happened, Tony actually had to get his appendix taken out. He was on the way to work and he just started getting some pain in his stomach and he just didn't feel well. He ended up going to an urgent care, and while he was there, they decided that he needed to go to the hospital immediately. They were going to call an ambulance for him, but he decided that he'd rather have me drive him, so that's what we did. A few hours later, we figured out that his appendix was on the brink of bursting, so they transferred him to a different hospital, and he had to have his appendix taken out. It totally caught us off guard. He was on his way to get some uniforms and other gear that you need when you're deploying, because he was supposed to deploy in January of last year, and since he had to have that surgery done, and then they put you on limited mobility after that, he wasn't able to go. So he ended up going in May. But during the summer, while he was deployed, I had all of these things go wrong. So it was just one thing after another. And if we didn't have an emergency fund set up, we would have got into debt really, really fast. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover each and every single item and tell you how to handle them. Okay guys, so the number one thing that you wanna have money set aside for is a car insurance deductible. Ours is $500, but a lot of people have theirs set at $1,000. That's fine. Either way, you want to go ahead and have that money set aside just in case something were to happen. Whether it's your fault or someone else's fault, you need to have that money set aside because a vehicle is your number one priority on how to make money, how you get to work, and how you get things done. The second thing that you always want to have money set aside for is home repairs. Like I mentioned before, we had to have our AC system replaced while Tony was deployed. This was very expensive. I want to say it cost almost $5,000. I'm not saying that you need to have the whole $5,000 in your emergency fund, but you do need to have a good amount set aside just in case something breaks down, like your refrigerator or your washer or dryer. These are all necessities that everybody needs, so you want to make sure that you have that money set aside. And the third thing is going to be money set aside for medical expenses. Now, this is unforeseen medical expenses. So not your routine things like your allergy medication or co-pays for any type of regular thing that you get. Items that are out of the ordinary, such as like breaking your arm or having your appendix taken out or something like that. Those are the co-pays that you want to have money set aside for. Because Murphy's Law will hit. When it's raining, it pours. So you want to make sure that you're protecting yourself. And what I mean by this is by having money set aside so that it doesn't just keep raining down on you. The amount that I recommend is at least $1,000, but if you can gather up $2,000, that's great. The best way to save up for this emergency fund is if you have any loans or credit card payments, set those to pay the minimum amount possible so that you stay current, but you want to set this to the minimum amount so that you can go ahead and start putting money aside for your emergency fund. Because while you're paying off debt, you don't want to incur more debt for an emergency. So go ahead and set all of your payments down to the minimum. If you have anything laying around that you're not using, sell it. So some examples of side hustles would be like babysitting, cutting yards, or, you know, picking up trash and going and dumping it for people. Things like that, things that people don't want to do, but they'll pay for someone else to do for them. That also are something that is very minimal investment for you. Most of us do have lawnmowers. Most of us do have somewhere where we can babysit a child, or you can go babysit a child at that person's house. So these are examples of ways to make some quick cash to go ahead and get your emergency fund set up. Now, my last tip for you is going to be having this money set aside into a savings account that is not linked to your checking account, because you might be tempted to use it. So you want to go ahead and set it up into a savings account where you can access it, but it might take you a couple days. So that way you're not tempted to spend that money. I'm going to cover this in a future video, but you might want to look into high yield savings accounts. These accounts give you a little bit more interest than a normal savings account would. And it's a great place to have your emergency fund because it's earning a little bit of interest. One of my favorite savings accounts is American Express Savings or CIT Bank Savings. CIT is C-I-T Savings Account. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments down below. I hope that you subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be making a lot more videos like this. I want to create a step-by-step guide on how I achieved financial success and how I can help you do the same. Thanks for watching. Bye!